Python and R are the two most commonly used languages in data science. And nowadays, most of the freshers get confused whether they should use R or Python to kickstart their career in the field of data science. Hey guys, this is Shubham from Intellipaat, and in this video, I'm going to tell you the long and short of both of these topics. So, without wasting more time, let's get started. I'm going to start off with their basic definitions. So, starting off with R. R is a programming language made by statisticians and data miners for statistical analysis and graphics supported by the R Foundation for Statistical Computing. R also provides high quality graphics, and it also has some popular libraries which help in analytical parts such as R Markdown and Shiny. Python, on the other hand, is a fully fledged object oriented and high level programming language made by programmers and developers for general purpose programming. Python is widely used in graphical user interface based applications such as games, graphic designs, web applications, and many more. So we can say that R's functionality is developed by statisticians' mind, thereby giving it a field specific advantages. While Python is often praised for being a general purpose language with an easy to understand syntax. Let us start from the first factor, that is the speed. So guys, when it comes to speed, Python is faster than R only till 1000 iterations. But after the 1000 iterations, R starts using the Laplace function, which increases its speed. In that case, R becomes faster than Python. So both have their own advantages, right? Moving forward to the next point, that is the code and syntax. In this topic, I'm going to give you a brief about the variable declaration, data handling capacity with the scatterplot visualization, and the class plot graphics. Starting off with variable declaration. So guys, I'm going to take the case of string here, as R uses a similar implementation to that of the S programming language, which uses arrow signs in order to initialize the variable, which was also present in case of S programming language. These arrows can be used from right to left or left to right, indicating whom to assign the variables, whereas Python uses an assignment operator to initialize the variables. So basically, R developers thought that it would be better to tell the direction of assignment rather than just using an assignment operator, which could actually confuse any new programmer about which variable is being assigned. Right. Next is the data handling capability. Here, I'm going to show you the case of scatter plots by which you will see the visualizations in R and Python. So guys, these are the piece of codes in R and Python, and after running these codes, you will get the very similar plot results in both the cases. If you try to analyze this code right here, then this clearly shows that how R's data science ecosystem has many smaller packages like ggally, which basically is a package that helps ggplot2, and also it is mostly used in R plotting package. Whereas in Python, matplot library, or we can call it matplotlib, is the primary plotting package, and seaborn is a widely used layer over the matplot library. So guys, these are the plot results that I was talking about. So you can see that the graph results of both R and Python are similar, but the only difference is the visualization, right? So based on these points and plot results, we can conclude that R has many packages supporting different methods of doing things, whereas there is usually one way to do something in Python. Moving on to the next point, that is the graphics. So here we will take the case of class plots. So guys, we already discussed that R was basically built for statistical analysis. So it has many specific libraries for plotting as well. This is the reason R comes up with many beautiful charts and graphs, whereas Python's main agenda was not a statistical analysis. So in the early stages of Python, packages for data analysis was an issue, but it has improved a lot. So guys, this is a plot result which is on your screen that I was talking about. As you know that the picture says more than 1000 words. So here you can see by yourself that R comes up with a beautiful graphical representation. So here we can say that R is handy when it comes to the data handling. Our next point of attention is the deep learning, which is today's trend. So as you all know that almost majority of the companies are working on artificial intelligence, and deep learning is the main part of artificial intelligence. So when it comes to deep learning, Python is more versatile than R, as it provides more features to deep learning, whereas R is new to deep learning. R has newly added APIs like Keras and Keras R, which are written in Python. So guys, somewhere in your mind, this question might be floating. Why Keras? Actually, Keras in Python has the capabilities to run over Python's strong APIs like TensorFlow or Theano or Microsoft's CNTK. So we can say that Python has a greater advantage here. Till now, we have seen that both are useful in their own terms, right? Moving forward to the next point, that is the percentage of switching. In the past years of research, the percentage of people switching from R to Python are more as compared to Python to R. Let us say, if 10% people are switching from Python to R, then 20% are switching from R to Python, which is twice as compared to the before scenario. Next, we are going to look at the trends, community support, and jobs. So guys, if we talk about the trends, before 2016, R was more in use. But here we can see that from 2016, Python is in trend. So it is more popular than R. And because of its popularity, it has overall good support for general purpose programming. So guys, if we talk about the community support, then Python's and R's support aspects are quite similar to each other. Because Python support is found at mailing list, user contributed code and documentation and Stack Overflow. So basically it has more adoption from developers and programmers end. Whereas R language support is also found at mailing lists, user contributed documentation and active Stack Overflow members. So basically R has more adoptions from researchers, data scientists and statisticians end. Now, if we talk about the job trends, let us check the Google job trends graph right here. So guys, this is the job postings of R and Python in past 12 months worldwide. Whereas Python is asked more as compared to R. How is it possible? Because of its popularity and its need in the current industry. Since Python is more versatile and an all-rounder programming language, which can be used for majority of the purposes, such as web application, game development, artificial intelligence, data science, statistical analysis, etc. Whereas R language is used among statisticians and data miners for developing statistical software and data analysis, which clearly depicts that there are more jobs for Python than R. Now let's move forward. So, which one to choose for data science, R or Python? So guys, this is a frequently asked question by the majority of the learners in this domain. I would suggest using both if you have the choice. Everything has their own pros as well as cons. So as in the case of R and Python, if we talk about pros in R, well, then R is great for prototyping and for statistical analysis. It has a huge set of libraries which are available for different statistical type analysis. Even RStudio IDE is definitely a big plus as it eases most of the tedious tasks and fastens your workflow. Talking about its cons, well, the syntax could be obscure sometimes and it is harder for it to integrate to production workflow. The library's documentation isn't always user-friendly. Talking about the pros in Python, Python is great for scripting and automating your different data mining pipelines. It is the de facto scripting language nowadays and it also integrates easily in a production workflow. Besides, it can be used across different parts of your software engineering team like for backend, cloud architecture, etc. The scikit-learn library in Python is awesome for machine learning tasks. Talking of its cons, then Python isn't as thorough for statistical analysis as R. But it has come a long way in these recent years. In my opinion, the learning curve is steeper than R, since you can do so much more with Python. To conclude it, I would like to say that you can use R and Python both. Learn and how they interoperate together. Start with one and then add another to your workflow. It only adds another skill set into your resume, which comes as an added bonus to your career, isn't it? So guys, now it's a wrap-up time. Thank you so much for watching this session. I would love to hear from you guys that which one according to you is better and why. Please reply to us in the comment section below. See you again.